You have been volunteering both time and money in a ton of places. One that caught my eye was the Wildcat Ridge Sanctuary in Oregon. You also donated $10,000 to that cause. Nurk, the idea of you with all those big cats, lions, tigers, how did you get involved with that? And the visual is just amazing to me when I think about it.
I think it's great. I think we gotta show the way, right? Obviously, with pandemic, I know it's all the people suffer, right? But then you have animals and sanctuaries who need the food, right? There's no like people coming in to see or donate. I think it was hard for them. So then we tried to help them with the food as much as they need during this time. But then go back, you know, try to do other things, like you said. So especially back home, I really focus on it. So.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, first of all, I think once things do open up a little bit more, you're going to have to get one or two of those tigers to come visit the Blazers locker room, because I feel that would go very well.
I would give that to the Tyson. I ain't play with them. Like
that might be only a Mike Tyson thing. But you mentioned doing other things as well. And I do want to give you a chance to talk about it, because you run down the list of what you have done in your native country of Bosnia. It's so impressive. What is the thing, of all the stuff you've done, and there's so much, we're going to show some on the screen here, what has been particularly meaningful to you?
I think what I care the most about is the kids, right? When I was, you know, a kid, you know, from 94, born there, just, you know, the end of the war, it was just tough. No chance, no opportunities. So I think for me personally, I'll invest, you know, my money and people around me, time to figure out the best way we can support the kids growing up. So, you know, try to feed, you know, there's a lot of poor people in Bosnia who don't have one meal a day, which is insane. Like how much money countries get and governments, you know, almost like a steal at them. So for me, you know, as an individual, you can change, you know, in fact, the people's lives, right? Back home, there's a thing like mammographs, and women need to wait more than 2 years to get a date. Just see mammograph machine, right? Which is insane. I feel like last 20 some years to wait 2+ years to just give a damn date, right?
No, it's terrible.
So we decided as my foundation to buy them, right? And donate them. We already have an agreement with the government in hometown to figure out the program for the women with the breast cancer, right? Mm-hmm. Awareness, to bring more awareness about it. So I think that's going to be huge.
So important. And the idea that you're getting involved in the Portland community, in the Bosnian community, they're all very lucky to have you. Now, before we let you go, I need to ask you about your dad, Nurk, and I need to get to the bottom of some of the NBA myth around you. So the story about you and how you ended up in basketball is that your dad was a police officer, 7 feet tall, 400 pounds. The story is that he fought off a group of 14 people by himself in the line of duty, that an agent read about him in the newspaper and decided any kid of his is going to be a good athlete, and that's what led to you being discovered. Is all of that true? Some of that true? If it's not true, I don't know if I want to know. Clear it up for me.
It is true. It is really true. He's just some big ass cop who have no, it's almost like he have own laws, right? So I have a little brother, he's 13 years old. He's huge. His shoe size number is 16 right now.
What? Now?
Yes. So he big ass kid, lefty. And I told Rich, he's gonna be top five in the draft. By the time he came, the basketball, I think, will go a little bit back with all the big guys we're drafting, luckily.
Yeah.
And as far as that, he's just big dude. And obviously, that was the story when he came out, and that's how I have a chance that the people hear about my dad. And then going forward, he just gave me a chance to play basketball. So, you know, from 14 years old, first time practicing, then to now, is like insane to have that short period of time playing basketball and being NBA in 5 years. So it was a kind of crazy journey, but you know, right now everything kind of settled down, so which is happy.
Well, I love that you're already giving us the scouting report on your younger brother, and we will expect him in the NBA soon as well. Nurk, thank you so much for joining us. Congratulations on all the really, really important work you're doing. Get healthy. Good luck to you in Portland the rest of the way.
Thank you so much, Rachel.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.